I look at you all the time, never let you know what I see in you. Let you know, but Jesus told me how to identify. You know, back in the day in World War II, they taught you how to identify different aircraft. Because if enemy aircraft would come over, you wouldn't shoot your own plane down. Lamont, did y'all have that? Y'all didn't have that? Did you have that? You had to identify, you had to identify by the fuselage and the wing, how the wing was made and everything to identify. The only thing we had back in that day, propeller plane. They all sound like, they all sound like, but you identify how they look. And then I was in an aircraft before they had guided missile. That means you see one, if you identified, he wasn't look like an American plane, you could shoot him down. But we had radar, and we sent a signal up to that plane. IFF, I forget what you call it. And if he didn't answer that signal, we know he was hostile plane. Bring him down. You bring him down. Now, if you're not a child of God, you're not getting to heaven. If you're not identified by the Spirit of God, the Bible does say, try the Spirit by the Spirit. See what it be of God. And I try it all the time among you. When I walk among you, I can identify you. Try the Spirit by the Spirit. See what, I don't ever have to tell you that, because you're going to lie if I tell you who you are. That sounds tough, doesn't it? But you're going to lie if I tell you you ain't right, because you want to hear me say you're good. And sometimes I know that some people are rotten. But now it might help you if I tell you what you are. But you don't want to hear that. But that's the only way I'm going to help you, and I'm telling you tonight. Only way that you can help you, and you search yourself. When a person tells you something, you go back to the Word of God and search yourself, and then talk with God at night. And say, Lord, if I'm not right, you take me and make me, mold me. Lord, I want to be right, I want to be saved, and I want to be whole. You got to tell God that, not nobody else. You got to do that for yourself. Jesus gives this parable by saying, all things are now ready. And he said, and he sent his servant at supper time and said to them that were bidden, come, for all things are now ready. And they all with one consent began to make excuses. And I run into that all the time in the church house. Everybody got an excuse. What they can't do. They would do, but they got an excuse. It's not to me. It's not for me. It's supposed to be for God, the Lord house. You know who keeping record? Monroe, I ain't keeping no record. You reading the book of Revelation, who got the record? I think somewhere in Revelation said two books gonna be open. The book of life and the book of death. And whosoever name not written in the book of life is written in the book of death. And Jesus in the book of Matthew, he said, depart from me, I know you're not. Out of all that you say you've done, he's going to say, I don't know you. Depart from me, I know you're not. You workers, you did it, but you workers of iniquity. All right. You sinful workers. All right. You did a whole lot of things, but what was your purpose? What was your motive? It's in the Word of God. It's right there. We fail to really teach what's in the Word. That goes forward to get us to heaven. Right. I'm looking at you, young man, you know, because you give me great men. The Word of God will tell us what we are lacking, what keeps us out of heaven. If we don't know what keeps us out, how we can get in? If we don't know what to dress ourselves up with. I got an invitation on my desk invitation to a wedding. And it said that the reception, everybody got to must have formal attire. That means you can't come in and look in any kind of way. If you don't have the right attire on, don't come. You're not invited. Same thing with God. Same thing with the Lord. On one point in the scripture, you say there came a man to the wedding that was in, Everybody was invited to a wedding. That woman came in with not with a wedding garment. And he told him, cast him out into utter darkness. Who would, what Jesus give me? He talking about us. If we come before him and when time come to an end and we not dressed up in our righteousness of Christ, he's going to take you and throw you into utter darkness. It's in the word. It left to you, brother and sister, to get ready to meet God. You better quit this shamming. People sure dying. They've been dying all the time, but they sure dying to those that you know now. They are dying getting out of here. Don't you know your name is on the roll? I know my name is there. I don't know when, where, how, but I know it's there. I want to be ready. I don't know about you. I want to be ready when he called my name. If you don't get ready, that's left for you. Mama, dad, sister, brother, if they don't get ready, I can't do nothing. I can't answer for them. They're my daughter and wife. I can't answer for them. My Patrick up there, I can't answer for him. Only my name. Rusley Monroe Jr. Here I am, Lord. You know, you can only answer for yourself. And he's going to call your name. Don't fool yourself. He's going to call your name. See, they all began to make excuses. I pray thee, have me an excuse. Wait a minute. First of all, if they had always wanted sin, they began to make excuses. The first one said unto him, I bought a piece of ground. You know, don't you hear people that church talking about what they got to do for themselves when they come down and do something for the Lord's house? It ain't for Reverend Monroe. I'll be... If the Lord don't destroy this building, it'll be here when I'm dead and gone. It's going to be here. It ain't for me. It's supposed to be for the Lord, for the worship of him. He said, the first one said unto him, I bought me a piece of ground, and I need to go and see it. How come you didn't see it before you buy it? You're going to buy it, and then tell me you need to go see it. That's an excuse. But Jesus said that's an excuse. What was he talking about? He talking about us. This is just a parable. He talking about that's how we are. Concerning the kingdom of God. We make excuses. He wasn't talking about this dinner here. He talking about how we make excuses. And y'all better teach these lessons like they are. Like they're supposed to be taught. Better talk to one another. Because you got to get right to meet God. You don't just teach it just to be teaching it. Brother Troy, to see how good you can teach. But you better teach it to get somebody right with God. Hello, somebody. Now I know I'm right about that. He said, I need to go see it. And then I pray thee have me excuse. I pray thee have me excuse. Will you excuse me? And another said, I bought 5 yoke of oxen. And I go to prove them. And I pray thee have me at supper time. Get dog, and he gonna go try his oxen out. But the Bible says that's you. It wasn't really that's you. He was lying. It's you. And another said, I have married a wife. That's another big excuse thing. You mean you just met her? I married a wife and therefore I cannot come. You just met her? Now, Jesus didn't leave a stone unturned. Not one. And then, he said, I cannot come. Then the servant came and showed his Lord all these things. And the master of the house being angry. That's what God's going to be with us. Y'all hear what I'm saying? He'll give you the invitation to come, and you give all kind of excuses. Well, you can't do this, but you can't do that. I got to do that. I can't. Not fulfilling his command. He said, now listen, he talking about God himself going to get angry. And so when it's like me, I go and report to him. That Mac didn't want to do this, Lord. Mac Jerome made another excuse, Lord. And Upshaw made another, and Washington made an excuse. Kendall made an excuse. Lamont made an excuse. And you know what he said? Then the master of the house being angry. He talking about God. Said unto his son, go quickly unto what? The streets. Unto the streets. And the lame of the city, and bring hither the poor, the maimed, the halt, and the blind. Just bring everybody. Yeah. And the servant said, Lord, it is done. He went and did what the Lord said. And thou